हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द चैनल वंस अगेन। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू एक्सप्लोर द वर्ल्ड ऑफ क्रिएटिविटी। ओके, द मेनी पीपल स्ट्रगल विथ स्ट्रमिंग पैटर्न। ओके, स्ट्रमिंग पैटर्न, दीज आर टू डिफरेंट वर्ड्स विथ टू डिफरेंट meanings. So today we will study the theory of strumming pattern. Strumming is nothing but playing the rhythm of the song. This rhythm is played along with the chords. I would like to say that I am a regular uploader of tutorial related to guitar and music. If you are a serious learner, please subscribe to my channel and hit the notification icon immediately. Question is, what is strumming? Strumming means hitting the strings. In guitar, strings can be hitted only in two directions. Number one, up, and number two, down. An upstroke or downstroke. So strumming means hitting the string up or down. Okay, now question number two, what is pattern? The pattern depends upon three factors. Number one, A, stroke direction. Number two, that is B, stroke timing, and C, stroke effect. So these three factors are responsible for creating a pattern. Now let's see first stroke direction. There are only two directions of strokes that can be applied in guitar. Number one, upstroke. Upstroke is diagrammatically represented as a V. Second is downstroke. It is represented diagrammatically as a box opened at the bottom. In downstroke, we generally hit the upper side three strings of the guitar. In the downstroke, our stroke is slightly inclined so that these three strings get more power than these three strings. Hence, a downstroke emits more of bass sound. In the upstroke, we generally hit like this. This gives much more power to the first three strings, that is the treble strings, the thinner strings, than the upper strings, that is 4, 5, and 6. So this gives more of treble sound, but these are subjected to your creativity and requirement. It is not always compulsory that you will hit it like this. You may hit all the strings equally up and equally down so that they make equal sound, all the strings. Let's come to the stroke timing. This is again a big topic of creativity. Okay, the upstroke and the downstroke might be very close. There are only two strokes, right? So combining these two strokes, this can be like quick or late. Okay, now this timing is again a subjected to creativity. Okay, but whatever is the timing between two strokes, they will follow the beat. In the first beat, if the timing between our upstroke and downstroke is 1 second, in the second beat also they will be same, otherwise it will sound weird. Okay, the third is stroke effect. This consists of muting effect. The two types of muting effects are: A, finger muting, the fingers with which you press the strings, and B, palm muting. Finger muting is symbolically represented as an X, and palm muting is represented with PM with dash either afterwards or before. We will discuss this in detail. So muting is nothing but strumming the strings with your fingers lightly attached to them. Okay, so that you hit the strings but you don't get the sound. Now when you combine the strumming is strokes up or down, sorry, down or up with the stroke timing and stroke effect, the resultant is a strumming pattern. In stroke timing, there can be one stroke, it can be up or down per beat. Two strokes, both can be up, both can be down, one can be up, one can be down per beat. Four stroke per beat, 8 stroke, 16 stroke and so on. There are stroke timings which are odd. Drilling and milling, all these three factors, stroke plus timing plus effect, we generate a strumming pattern. Now let's go to the guitar, okay, and see these theory in practical. So friends, let's check out the strumming pattern on the guitar. Strumming means two strokes, a downstroke and an upstroke, right? Now this downstroke and upstroke are little inclined as I showed you in the diagram, okay? Let me show you with a closer look. When I hit this, right now I am hitting all the strings with the same pressure. Downstroke and this is upstroke. Now I can hit it little inclined way so that I give more pressure to the bass strings and less pressure to the treble strings. Like this. See, in fact I am not hitting the last three strings. Okay, now upstroke is the reverse of downstroke. I will hit more of the treble string and less of the bass strings. Like this. And even if I hit this, the pressure will be very low. See? And downstroke. So these are the strokes. One is all string with the same pressure, downstroke with pressure on the bass string, and upstroke with a pressure on the treble string. Okay, now comes the stroke timing. It can be like this. It can be like this. It can be very fast. It can be two strokes fast, two strokes slow. Now, if you hold a chord, I will just hold a chord. I'll hold the C chord. Let's get see the very basic stroke, that is one up, one down. The timing is same according to the beat. I am hitting all the strings. Now I will hit the bass strings in the downstroke and treble strings in the upstroke. Right, I will now decrease the timing. See, bass stroke and treble stroke. Now I will modify these two strokes again. I'll change the strokes. I'll change the timing again. I'll increase the tempo. I'll increase the tempo further. I'll change the strokes. I will apply two stroke down and one stroke up. See the timing? Different timing. This is absolutely a big world of creativity. This is your own guitar. Experiment with your own guitar. Play different strokes, play different timings and experiment. Remember, rhythm is creative. Rhythm pattern is very, very creative. There are, consider just two strokes, upstroke and downstroke. Now, how many formats you can form? Up, 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 down, down, up and down, down. Four formats with these two strokes. Now comes the effect part, that is muting. Without muting. Now, I'll just leave the... Okay. I'm hitting the strings, but sound isn't coming. I'm doing all downstrokes. First is hitting all the strings without muting, then it's muting. This is finger muting. There is palm muting. Used while strumming the guitar to give beautiful rhythm. See, very simple. Down, down, up. Down, down, mute, down. Down, down, mute, down. Down, down, mute, down. Change the timing. Or this can be done with this also. So this is a complete different world of creativity. You can actually experiment with this. द मोर यू एक्सपेरिमेंट द मोर रिदम यू कैन बिल्ड द मोर यू विल गेट फ्लुएंट विद द रिदम द मोर यू विल गेट फ्लुएंट विद द एफेक्टिंग पार्ट यू कैन प्ले योर ओन रिदम इन डिफरेंट सॉन्ग्स एंड दैट कैन बी मच मोर ब्यूटिफुल क्रिएट योर ओन इफेक्ट्स क्रिएट योर ओन पैटर्न रिमेंबर देर आर ओनली टू स्ट्रोक्स म्यूटिंग ओनली टू टाइप्स ऑफ म्यूटिंग एंड डिफरेंट टाइमिंग्स जस्ट एक्सपेरिमेंट मिक्सिंग दिस इज एन इन्फिनाइट वर्ल्ड ऑफ स्ट्रमिंग पैटर्न इज एन इन्फिनाइट वर्ल्ड इट हैज नो लिमिट्स क्रिएट ओन एक्सपेरिमेंट योर ओन From the next video, I will start teaching the strumming pattern one by one. From the simple, then I will move on to complex. Okay? Subscribe if you want to learn the strumming patterns from next lesson. I hope you understood the concept and theory behind strumming pattern. See you again. Thank you.